Hello, everyone, and welcome to Fourth Presbyterian Church in Chicago. My name is John Shear, and for nearly 25 years, I've been the organist and director of music for this wonderful congregation. I'm very excited about tonight's program because it's a celebration of many things. First, it's a celebration of Chicago composers, many of whom are in this program tonight. It's also a celebration of the fifth anniversary of the dedication of the Andrew Pipe Organ. This pipe organ came together through the efforts of many people, committees and staff here at the church, donors, hundreds of them, including the Andrew Family Foundation. It also was the work of the Quimby Pipe Organ Company and Mike Quimby, along with his wonderful team. This organ has been hailed by many for its diverse colors and its wide range of sounds, capable of playing truly any repertoire. We're going to begin tonight's program with the music of Clarence Eddy. This is his Voluntary in A major. Clarence, it is said, liked to practice 6 to 10 hours each day. This is a good thing because for 2 years, he performed a different concert every Sunday afternoon. Clarence was the organist at First Presbyterian Church here in Chicago, and here is his Voluntary in A major. Our next piece is by Eric Delamarter. Delamarter was the organist and director of music here at Fourth Presbyterian Church from 1914 until 1935. He was also assistant conductor of the Chicago Symphony and was promoted to become the associate conductor of the Chicago Symphony. In addition, he was a music critic here in Chicago, so he was quite a busy person. This next piece, the Suite for Organ, was composed in 1945, and it's in three movements, Flourish, Melody, and Scherzo. And particularly the melody sounds a bit like a Hollywood soundtrack, I think, which is appropriate because the year after he composed this piece, he wrote the soundtrack for the Hollywood movie Humoresque, and he even starred in that movie. So this is The Suite by Eric Delamarter.
Thank you.
Our next piece is the Jig for the Tuba Stop by Donald Stewart Wright. Donald was a good friend. He was a very dapper gentleman. He always had a bow tie on and was dressed to the nines. He was the organist for many years at St. Christopher's Episcopal Church in Oak Park. He wrote this piece for his young son, Michael. And it may seem odd that it's a Jig for the Tuba Stop. You don't normally think of a tuba as an instrument to accompany a jig. Well, the tuba stop on the organ is just the grandest trumpet stop. Tuba is Latin for trumpet. And so this is really a jig for the trumpet stop, and I hope that you enjoy this piece. Prelude on a Melody by Sowerby was written by Morgan Simmons. Morgan was my predecessor here at Fourth Presbyterian Church. He was the organist and choir master from 1968 until 1996. He based this composition on a melody by Sowerby, and the melody is the anthem called Eternal Light. He dedicated this piece to his wife Mary, who was the associate organist here at Fourth Church from 1968 until 1996. This is the Prelude on a Melody by Sowerby. Thank you. Next, we have three settings of hymn tunes, three very different settings. The first is by Paul Motz. Paul was the cantor at St. Luke's Lutheran Church on Belmont Avenue. I was at the National Convention a few years before Paul passed away, in which he was given a national award, and 2,000 organists jumped to their feet, giving him a standing ovation, because Paul Motz was so highly regarded in our profession. He wrote dozens of chorale preludes, arrangements of hymn settings, and this setting, God of Grace, is probably one of the most popular. After that, I'll play a piece by Richard Webster, who was for many years organist and choirmaster at St. Luke's Episcopal Church in Evanston. This arrangement of a Swedish hymn is called Thy Holy Wings. And I'll finish with Clarence Dickinson's stirring setting of O Quanta Qualia, which he entitled The Joy of the Redeemed.
Thank you.
Leo Sowerby came to Fourth Presbyterian Church as the associate organist in 1917 and soon after composed this beautiful piece called Carillon. This piece features many of the orchestral sounds of the organ, including the harp and the chimes. Leo Sowerby left Fourth Presbyterian Church and went on to become organist and choirmaster at St. James Church, which was to become St. James Cathedral, just a few blocks away from Fourth Presbyterian Church. I hope that you enjoy Leo Sowerby's Carillon. Richard Prue, for many years, was the organist and director of music at Holy Name Catholic Cathedral. This fanfare is quite unusual because you normally think of a fanfare as being a very solid piece of music. Richard had a lot of fun with this piece and wrote it in many different time signatures, many different meters, and at times even put time signatures on top of each other. So the feet on the pedal part may be in one time signature while the hands are in a different time signature. So it's a bit quirky. But this is The Fanfare by Richard Prue. Florence Price was born in Little Rock, Arkansas, and moved to Chicago in 1927. She studied organ and piano at the New England Conservatory of Music in Boston and came back to Chicago, where she studied organ with Leo Sowerby. It's quite possible that Florence Price even had organ lessons right here at Fourth Presbyterian Church. This next piece, called In Quiet Mood, is an absolutely beautiful piece. She wrote over 300 compositions and was the first African-American woman to have her music performed by major American symphony, no less than the Chicago Symphony Orchestra. So this is In Quiet Mood by Florence Price.
Thank you.
I hope that you've enjoyed this celebration of Chicago composers on the magnificent Andrew Pipe organ here at Fourth Presbyterian Church. I'm going to finish with National City Fanfare by Aaron David Miller. Aaron was the associate organist here at Fourth Presbyterian Church from 1999 until 2001, and he's now the organist and director of music at House of Hope Presbyterian Church in St. Paul, Minnesota. He composed National City Fanfare while he was here at Fourth Presbyterian Church, and I can just hear him playing it. So I hope you enjoy National City Fanfare by Aaron David Miller. Thank you. I'd like to play one more piece for you. This is by Aaron David Miller, and it's his fantasy on the English folk melody, O Wally Wally. I played this a few weeks ago in church, and a friend said it was like a glimpse of heaven. So I'd like to give you just this short glimpse of heaven. Stay safe, everyone, and much love to you all. Thank you. Hello, everyone, and welcome to Fourth Presbyterian Church in Chicago. My name is John Shear, and for nearly 25 years, I've been the organist and director of music for this wonderful congregation. I'm very excited about tonight's program because it's a celebration of many things. First, it's a